This is final week at Bard College. People are struggling, but there's still American who care about Hong Kong Meng, and I'm very impressed.
I mean, your question is in English or in Chinese?
English, but you can answer in Chinese.
Yeah, but I'm not sure if I can understand your question.
I don't understand. Okay. Mm-hmm. 你叫什么名字?
我叫孙海平.
你家在哪里?
在青岛.
青岛在中国?
对,在中国。好好好。
My name's Jiawei, and I'm from China, Henan province.
I'm Yiqing, and I'm from Taiwan.
杨炳文.
你家在哪里?
我家在天津.
Stephen, I'm from Guangdong, China.
English or Chinese, both.
You can choose.
我的名字叫柯润东, 我来自上海.
From?
My name's Jimin, and I'm from Wuhan in China.
我叫张思聪, 我家在沈阳.
我叫倪雪韵.
你的家在哪里?
在南京.
My name is Yang Li, and I'm from Harbin.
Yunxian, China.
Where are you from in China?
Mm-hmm. I'm Nanking.
So my name is Jin. I'm from China. Specifically, which city?
The city's name is Shenyang. It's like in the northeast part of China.
My name is Dennis, and I'm from New Jersey. My parents are originally, they were all born in Shanghai, but they work in Beijing for a while.
I'm Yige. I'm from China.
Where in China?
Should I just say the name of the city?
Sure.
Okay, Chengdu.
Chengdu
in Sichuan province.
Okay.
I'm Yi Liu, and I'm from Dalian, China.
When did you first read Dream of the Red Chamber?
You mean the whole book or the like simplified? I read like the story probably in like elementary school, but I read the original book in like middle school, high school.
So what the first time you read just the story, it was just a
like it's like a
shorter
version? Like a shorter version,
okay.
For like kids.
And then you read it a few times afterwards?
Yeah, I read the original one like a few times.
Afterwards. How many times have you read it?
Probably like 4 or 5 times.
Really?
Yeah. This is my favorite book.
It's
like
your favorite
I have
book?
It in my like nook.
Uh-huh.
So I like read some chapters, whatever.
Very, very young. Very, very young.
How old?
I couldn't remember.
How many times have you read the book?
3 times?
Yeah.
2 or 3 times.
2 or 3 times? Is it your favorite book?
Kind of. Could
uh-huh.
be, yeah.
How many times have you read it?
Like once. Twice, I don't remember. Well, I was very young. I don't remember. Maybe like in my primary school, I think. Yeah. 5th grade or 6th grade. Yeah.
The entire thing?
Yeah. Well, I usually I don't like entirely read it, so. But maybe like 8 times, I guess.
When I was in 9th grade. And I reread it when I'm here about last year. So that's like the first year of my college.
One of your favorite books?
Yeah.
Is it your favorite?
Yeah.
Like, 小时候, like 12 years old.
And how many times have you read it?
I always read the beginning but then stopped. Like, it's too long.
Started to watch the TV series since I was 10 and I didn't really understand it, but my parents loves that book, so I started to read like several chapters of it, and then I watched the TV series after that, so I fell in love with this book. So yeah.
How many times have you read it?
I read some like chapters like several times, but some chapters I didn't read
mm.
at all. Yeah.
学的时候.
Mm.
In my high school.
Mm-mm.
对，我对中学的时候我开始读，读过几次。 知道，我觉得可能3-4次。
嗯。
因为有的时候 just a part of them, not the whole book. Yeah.
I don't know, 10, 11. Kids version.
How many times have you read it?
Plenty.
Hmm?
Plenty.
10?
Plenty. I can't remember.
3, 20?
Many times.
Many times?
Yeah.
Many times. Have you ever read the full version?
Yeah.
Have you read that more
twice.
Than once? Twice? Have you ever seen it on TVs, movies?
Yeah, definitely. TV shows.
Dramas? Yeah, like the older version and newer version.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think comic books also, I saw some of them. Yeah.
Mm.
I mean, 我看过《红楼梦》的电影，还有电视剧。
I watched the 粤剧 版本, you know?
The drama?
Yeah, the drama.
I've watched the 1987, the TV series. I've watched that for several times as well.
Uh-huh.
I have the DVD of that. And I've watched this, you know, this 粤剧. It's like a opera type in like Shanghai.
Okay.
They have that as well.
I started reading 1 to 12, but I didn't finish it, and I picked it up again when I was 14.
How many times have you read it?
Once, actually. But I read a lot of lectures on the book.
Uh-huh.
I saw some episodes of the old drama. Yeah, and there's a lot of like televised lectures.
Have you read Dream of the Red Chamber before?
No, I didn't. That's a shame, I know. But it's famous, and I've seen... like there's this TV series about this book every like summer break, but I don't know, I just didn't have the chance and time to watch the TV series or just read through the whole book. But I do want to read it because it is like one of the most famous like novel in China. Another reason I didn't have a chance to read Hong Lou Meng is that I spent all the time in my childhood watching XieXie again and again because I do love the story.
看过电视读的很少，小时候读过，不是那种最传统的那个版，不是最正宗的那个版本。后来就更对《红楼梦》没有太多兴趣，就觉得这种不怎么喜欢看，更喜欢看另外三本，什么《三国》啊，《水浒》。
嗯，
对，《三国演义》《水浒传》那种，就是从小男生更喜欢那一种嘛。
嗯。
I read a lot of Chinese novels, but not that.
西游记。
西游记啊。
三国演义。Why didn't you read《红楼梦》
？Why didn't I? First, I was told that it's a hard piece of novel. I mean, it's just a hard piece to read. And I wasn't interested because the drama, I thought it was like for girls only.
Unfortunately not. Why? I chose to
read
other
books.
Why haven't
you read?
I chose to read the other three. And
which books?
XieXie, The Journey to the West, 水浒传, and 三国演义. Yeah. In my opinion, I think those books are more suitable for younger boys.
So which character is your favorite character in the book, and why?
Oh, I think this is very difficult. Because there are many people.
I'll say Lin Daiyu.
I really like Lin Daiyu. I think I like her best.
You mean women or men?
Either.
I like Lin Daiyu compared to Xie Bao Chai.
Definitely not Lin Daiyu.
You don't like Lin Daiyu?
No.
为什么？
You know, I'm not, I just don't enjoy seeing the girls being like, I'm sick, I feel bad, you know, this kind of, it's, I'm so poor, people don't love me, I'm having such a poor life. Nah.
Can I ask Chinese, right?
Yeah.
Because I think...其实按现代人的目光来看，薛宝钗的性格更适合就是现在的社会生存。
嗯。
但是我觉得林黛玉那种比较率真的性格，我更加喜欢。
嗯。
First of all, she's really smart, and she like she probably like writes the best poems and everything, and also she, especially in that like.Setting, you know, like she's, I think like Cao Xueqin writes her as like a representative that kind of like a new type of women, you know, like not in that, because Because in that kind of like society, you would think that Shi Bao Chai is the one that is like everyone's favorite because she knows how to interact with people and she has all this like social skills.
Mm-hmm.
But Lin Naiyu is like I like him, so I want to be with him. Like he's very like modern. He's like a modern like character rather than the one that's in that kind of like Asian China.
Uh-huh.
And also she doesn't care about how do you say, 公民, like you take exams and then you become like a official, something like that. Like I'm not saying that you shouldn't do that, but since she's so different, she represents like a new kind of ideas, which is very innovative.
Uh-huh.
None of them. Yeah, I don't think I like any of them.
I like Lin Daiyu a little bit, but most time I hate her. She's always so sad and like she. I know she pursues her like love very actively, although everyone like doesn't agree with her, but still. She's always crying and like, oh, why don't you love me? Why do you like hang out with other girls? Like, she's so pathetic.
晴雯?
为什么?
她的性格很特别。 别的女孩子都比较温柔。 可是她的性格很强。
很漂亮。
每个女孩子都很漂亮，晴雯也很漂亮，对吗？可是她的性格怎么说？如果她喜欢或者她不喜欢，她会很清楚的说出来。
I like 王熙凤。
为什么？
My mom says she's my role model. because she knows how to handle everyone. Like she knows the social rule. Like the other end, she knows how to please everyone. She's very successful.
王熙凤.
为什么?
Well, she's a strong woman. And I don't like the characteristic of Lin Daiyu and Shi Bao Chai. I think they are both too extreme on both sides. And I think they should be mixed together to be a better man. I think Wang Xifeng is good at manipulating people and can have a good relationship with other people. Yeah, that's why I like her.
I think they are. Well, no, I like none of them.
You dislike them?
Yeah, like the two main characters are too weak.
Too weak?
Yeah, and then the other one is too, the other female one is too strong.
Like, Wang Xifeng?
Yeah, I think they're very representative. Like, they are the extreme of their characters.
Like, personalities of every, you know, character that I like. I'd say probably Shi Bao Chai.
为什么?
Because she's able to sacrifice, or you would probably call it compromise, her own identity, her own privileges, or, you know, her everything for the sake of the whole family. And she's able to realize the importance of maintaining the peace of the family. And seriously, she's the only character who hasn't really demonstrated, you know, strong sense of jealousy, which is not very common among the characters, the female characters that are described in the book.
I think Xue Bao Chai.
Xue Bao Chai?
Right.
为什么?
She's smart and she's more down to earth and she really knows how to manage stuff. So she knows what is going on.
Probably the better one.
为什么?
She is not as, you know, Wang Xifeng is this kind of very bossy, just strong, selfish maybe character. Shi Bao Chai, she's not as like Lin Daiyu, like it's kind of,
everyone should love me because I'm so poor.
But she has her personality, but in a very... I just enjoy the way she, you know, interacts with other people.
说不上来太多，因为感觉男的也太没有那种是我最喜欢的那种形象的那种人，刘姥姥，
刘
也，
为什么？
就是可能在那里面的那种，算是一种没有，我是觉得算一种比较可以比较正派或怎么说这种的一个人。也不算是正牌吧，反正还算比较喜欢的一个类型，只是。
Which character do you relate to the most?
I understand some of the thoughts she had and why she was so sad or like fragile all the time. Because I was like, I don't know.I understand some thoughts for
her. You relate to them?
Yeah. We're connected inside.
This is also hard.
Relate, like myself?
Yeah.
Oh.
Personally.
I would say Wang Xifeng.
Wang Xifeng?
I like her a lot too. She's very... how do you say that? 能干. Is that in English?Like she knows how to do stuff, and she does everything so like efficient and like effective. She would be like a great boss.
王熙凤，哦，因为她需要跟很多很多人怎么说打交道。
嗯。
她要管理这个很大的家，对吗？
嗯。
她要每天做很多工作，
嗯、
她要想哦，这个人今天应该做什么，那个人应该做什么，这个事情多少钱，那个事情我应该怎么办？所以，我觉得她、怎么说？她每天很忙。
嗯。
还有她很有能力，我觉得可能和我们在生活中有的时候很像。
Yeah, much fun is a character I like a lot.
You like Wang Xifeng?
It's not necessarily I like, but it's an interesting character. She's quite cutthroat, actually.
She's
not let anybody take advantage of her, pretty much.
And who do you think the hero in the book is? Do you think there's a hero in the novel? Who do you think the hero is?
Hero?
If there is a hero.
I don't think there's a hero.
Do you think if there,
the hero of the
if book. There is one, and why?
Huh, the hero of the book.
I don't see anyone as particular as hero actually. Like each one had their own fault and the bad qualities as well as good qualities. And I don't think it's like trying to promote hero or anything.
Not really. It's not a novel about hero.I mean, you know, it's not like 水浒传 or 西游记. It's about all these relationship issues.
The hero?
可能没有.
No, I don't think there's a hero.
Tan Chun?
Yeah, because Wang Xifeng was sick.And Tan Chun, Xu Baochai, and the other girls have to take charge of the whole family. Li Wan, yeah. So Tan Chun demonstrated like strong executive skills or something.
Mm-hmm.
Wang Xifeng.
Wang Xifeng?
Yeah.
为什么？
我很佩服他。
嗯。
Yeah, 因为 because I would never have that kind of
responsibility.
Yeah, and personality.Yeah, to manage so many complicated stuff within this.
I would say Wang Xifeng. She's a female, but she kind of like take charge of the whole family, and she does it so well. And without her, it's probably, even though she did a lot of bad things, like she take money for herself and stuff like that, but she still contribute a lot to the family.
I remember she did lots of bad things, but in 粤剧I didn't see
see that, so I don't remember.
Think about Jiao Baoyu.
He's a male hooker.
Favorite passage, chapter, or scene from the book?
Several ones I really did like. I like the one that when Yuan Chun comes to visit, and then because they have all this like poems, and they like did all this like good like writings and stuff. It's really fun. And I also like when Liu Lao Lao comes to Douglas. It's really really funny too. And I also like this one that when Dai Yu and Xiang Yun, they two like sitting along, it's probably very late in the book, like 70s, like to 80s, that they sat together and then they were doing poetry, like one by one, you know, like one says a sentence, one says like another. I like that a lot. I like, mostly I like when they're like doing poems, like when they're like together and like doing poems.
Who's poetress most? Because the normal text of the book, like throughout the books, it's like really modern Chinese already. So it's not that different from other books I've read in modern language, modern Chinese. But the poetress were like emotions of different characters. And the poetress put them together. Yeah, so.
My first thing is actually Dai Yu Zang Hua.
Zang Hua, she bears flowers.
She bears the flowers.
Why?
Because I watched the Yue Ju, and in this scene, it's so beautiful, and all the like the poetries come out. And I said, I see like her complex inner conflict, you know, and how she loves Bao Yu, and she sees him like going out with other people, and like I don't remember it very well, but I remember it's a very beautiful scene, and I really identify with her feelings.
我很喜欢这本书里的很多诗.
Yeah.
我觉得很好.
为什么?
因为这个曹雪芹他真的是很伟大的文学家。
他的那个小说那个story那个故事很好，可是每一句诗也很好，所以我很喜欢里面的诗。就是林黛玉和那个就是楚湘云，他们在一个就是在是挖金馆，嗯，演诗是吧？那一段我喜欢那一段。为什么？因为我很喜欢那一句韩唐多喝饮，月葬花还的诗，然后还有一个就是什么，就是葬花词那个，黛玉葬花那段很有名。
Are there any parts of the book you don't like or you wished were removed?
Wish.
You wish they weren't part of the book.
Oh.
You didn't like them.
Well, I never thought about that because I look at it as a whole story, never stops.
I mean, I didn't really read it in a very critical way when I read it. It's just like novel and big story. I might have some thought to where like this person should do this, but like I wasn't reading it in a way like how this book should be, you know, added.
Are there any parts of the book you don't like?
I don't like the chapters after 80. I'd say probably the later 40 chapters. Or, I mean, I might be influenced by how Liu Xingwu interpreted the whole book. Because he said there are like a lot of hidden like threat. So first of all, those suggestions were not realized. And the story was like ended in sort of like a semi-hilarious way. Those people who are supposed to die, some of them died, like Lin Daiyu, but like the reunion of Jia Baoyu and Xu Baochai in a semi-happy way, and also the ending of a lot of characters just doesn't really make that much sense.
So I think that's why I don't really like appreciate the last 40 chapters.
Hmm. 40 chapters, chapter 80 to chapter 120.
You mean
the Gao'e version?
I didn't reach that.
You didn't reach
that?
Yeah,
because I don't think it's as important as the first half of it.
I don't like the latter part of the book.
The 80 through 120?
No, it just doesn't feel right.
Wait, someone.
I don't think the original author is going that way. It's like this family is going down, and Jia Baoyu turns into a monk. And a lot of stuff doesn't make any sense, actually.
Because they didn't. You know, the author is like, oh, he didn't write it as the Cao Shuqi intended to. He changes a lot of like the school endings, like the plot, and also the language is not as good. Like he's unable to recreate the feelings of that family, which has like really rich and is really high social standard. I think this is like one really famous example that he made Dai Yu eat da tou cai. Do you know what it is? It's kind of like a preserved vegetable, something like pickles, a little bit like that. But like, it's very obvious that in that social standard, like young lady, like such rich family, won't even eat that kind of food. Or something. Like in details, you can see that he doesn't like follow the.
There's almost no poetry in the last part either.
Yeah, I think he just lacks the writing.
So would you prefer the book ended at 80?
I mean, someone might want to read like the end of the book, but like it's good that they have an ending, but for those who doesn't want to read, can just read.
Is a good depiction of Chinese culture and our Chinese family?
I think so.
Well, it's, you know, the tradition of Chinese family, a big family all living together and have a lot of conflicts and about love. Yeah.
It's fairly accurate, if not average family, but at least like for the aristocrat, pretty much, like rich people. I think it's really accurate. I think he used from the family, right? The author is talking to him. He's used from a family like that. And the book is really like detailed and elaborate on a lot of different aspects.
I think so. It's really, especially like those rich families, it's really huge, but he did like a really good job at like interacting people and how they're like connected, and then you may like how you socialize with people, even maybe you like or don't like them, and everyone like their emotions are really, how do you say, they don't like express themselves as much, which is actually a very typical Chinese, you know, like you may like or don't like someone, but you don't say it out loud. You have to, like, the reader have to feel like, does he really likes her? Does she really like to like something like that?
I think Westerners can understand the novel?
Not really. Yeah.
Wait, someone.
I think it's too long, and it's too long, like, and the language is hard to understand.
肯定是可以的，文化还是可以，但是那种，那尤其是在那个时期写出来的，曹雪芹写的这个还是不是，可能不能特别完全的了解吧，还是可以感受到，但是可能不一定像当这么了解，当时就连中国人可能都不是那么完全可以读懂。
我觉得贾宝玉和林黛玉 they are very like liberal thinking. They are not like controlled by their parents. They just pursue what they want. I think Western will identify with them, like approve them better.
Really hard. There's a lot of puns in the poems, and there's a lot of a lot of details about their life, and a lot of their lifestyle, and it's really different from Western novels of the same time, I'd say.
Do you think if you don't read the book in Chinese, you can still understand it?
You can still understand the gist and the story, but you lose a lot of cultural aspect and a lot of literary aspect. There are a lot of great poems and a lot of like puns and rhymes, which I don't think will be there if you translate in English.
They can, but maybe they should to learn something about Chinese character, Chinese cultures, yeah, and some ancient Chinese, 中国古代汉语。
嗯。
因为我觉得，如果你看英文的翻译，我不知道那个是不是非常好，对吗？但是我觉得可以理解。
I've never read the Western version, the translation of it, so it's really, you know, there are so many things in the traditional, like classical Chinese, that's really hard to just translate the meaning into a different language. It's this kind of like cultural background that will help you to understand many things inside, which will be taken away when for someone, like some Westerners who doesn't like,I mean, you have some kind of background, but most people don't. So it'll be hard for people to understand. It might just feel like another oriental, exotic literature. But
I think so, because I think there are similar stories in every country, in that kind of society.
I doubt if they can fully understand it, but I think it's a very good like, way for them to see, oh, this is how Chinese think about that. Like, it's more like they get to know more about Chinese cultures and stuff.
Do you think if you read the book, if you don't read the book in Chinese, you can understand the book?
If there's a like professor like explaining things, I think that would be more helpful.
Mm-hmm.
But I would recommend reading the original, the Chinese version.